All right. This call, you're from Florida. Are you really listening, or are you calling in for a session? Hello? If you can hear me, the individual who's calling in from Florida, I cannot hear you. Hello? You may have to hang up and try again. Just hang up and try again because I cannot hear you if you are speaking. It's showing on my control panel that you're calling in from the phone, and I have unmuted you, but if you're speaking, I cannot hear you.
I'm sorry, I was muted.
Okay. All right. Okay, I can hear you now. So are you just listening or calling in for a session?
I'm listening, but I do, my family is under attack, and, you know, we've been praying and picking up praying things, and I pray prayers throughout the night while my family is sleeping, and one of them is the spiritual wives or the spiritual husband for deliverance, and I know my family, for a fact, especially my husband, has been battling the spirit of Baal.
With spirit of what?
Baal.
Spirit of Baal, okay. So in other words, what you're doing, you're mainly talking about the need of your family to be delivered and not yourself.
Well, myself too.
Okay.
I'm sleep at night sometimes. I can be facing the wall and I feel like, somebody's kissing me on my lips and I...
Now, did you just say you see what on the wall?
No. I said I'd be facing the wall, sleep.
You're facing the wall, sleep, but then you feel like something is kissing you on the lips.
Yes, like I woke up to something pecked me on my lips.
Now, what's your first name on? Just give me your first name.
It's Melissa.
Melissa, okay. Now, I'm going to ask you, how did you find out about me?
Through YouTube.
Okay. So have you been following me for a little while? I know some people have been following me 1, 2, 3, 4 years.
No, just recent.
Okay, just recent. God led you to our YouTube channel. Well, praise the Lord. I'm glad you called in. I don't like that when you said something kissing on the lips. So that sounds like a spirit husband. So are you aware of spirit spouses?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. How did you find out about spirit spouses?
Through watching the YouTube video. Just listening to the teachings through your videos,
Okay. All right. We're going to trust the Holy Spirit to. I don't know if you were listening to the session I just had with Jeffrey, but I always like to trust the Holy Spirit and to reveal to us when actually you were espoused in the spirit realm, or marry in the spirit realm to the spirit that's claimed to be your husband. Even though in the natural realm you have a physical husband, in the spirit realm there's a spirit who also has been claiming to be your husband before you even got married in this natural realm. And that's what it was that kissed you on the lips. And but it only aimed is to kill and to destroy your destiny in Christ Jesus, and also to dissolve your marriage as well, to dissolve your marriage. But the number one way, Melissa, that this spirit is assigned to a person is through some type of childhood molestation. Now, you've been listening to my video messages. As you were listening, what have the Holy Spirit brought back to your remembrance regarding a childhood molestation?
Yesterday, and that's the thing, I hadn't even said anything to you about that, but it did happen. So praise God. When I was a young child, my mother would leave me with my stepfather, And when she would leave me with my stepfather around a certain time, I couldn't think of the time, but it was always a TV show that came on.
Mm-hmm.
And just, I mean, I haven't heard it recently, but just recently, as of yesterday, I heard that theme show or that song come, you know, the thought of that theme show come and play in my head.
Mm-hmm.
So,
mm-hmm. What's the name of the show? I'm curious.
The something in KRP in Cincinnati, it was a radio, like a radio show.
Okay. I think I know what you're talking about, KRP.
Yes, yes, uh-huh. And so when that theme show would come on or that show would be on, you know, that's when my mother would be gone. And that's when the situation would take place. And I'm almost 40 years old. You know, he's been prosecuted and everything. But the thing about it is that it's been years and I had not even thought about it, don't even, you know, it doesn't even cross my mind. But just last night, it came across, you know, and I was like, wow, you know. But, you know. So.
Mm. Well, that's when that spirit was assigned to you was through that childhood molestation. Mm-hmm. Jesus, we think, but God's going to disconnect you from that relationship. You're about to get divorced. This is divorce that Jesus Christ wants us to be divorced from these spirits in the spirit realm who are claiming to be human being spouses. When the Lord says there's no such thing as gender or marriage or giving in marriage in the spirit realm. But you know the devil, he's going to do contrary to what God say do. So this is divorce that actually is supposed to be happening, not physical divorces, you see. So you didn't even know that you was already married. I'm going to be honest with you. Your husband also is married in the spirit realm because there is that spirit wife there because darkness only attracts darkness. Darkness attracts darkness. So God's going to set you free today, but you trust the Holy Spirit's timing so that you can talk to your husband. You know, let him know about this childhood molestation. Let him know.
Okay. And I have talked to my husband, and I asked him, I said, have you ever had dreams where you having, you know, sex with people? He said, yes. I said, you're not supposed to. So he
did.
Right.
Yeah, that spirit claimed to be his wife. That thing is there. You know, the Lord just said, this is what happens, the Lord said, with you two. Here you two in the bed. You two in the bed together. You only see each other, the Lord say. But right in the middle, facing you, is your spirit husband. Facing him is his spirit wife. That's what the Lord sees. And these spirits work in cohorts together to, first of all, come against God's destiny, come against your destiny in God. And also, eventually, it will come against your marriage. And also, it will have you two doing things in the bedroom that should not be done. But because you say you marry, you see, it pleases the eyes of God when it does not. That's a fetishism. There's a lot of fetishism in the marital bed, and that is not of God. Those are the acts of demon spirit. That's their child play. Sexual play, the Lord say. But God is such a loving and gracious God. He said when we were yet sinners, he died for us. He has forgiven us. You know, when we come to the Lord and ask him to forgive us for things that we know we have done wrong and things that we did not know, he is graceful and merciful in forgiving us. That's the beauty about God. He is a forgiving God. God did not condemn us. Therefore, we should not listen to the enemy and condemn ourselves. As long as we come to repentance, as long as we admit to our wrongdoing, God says he can forgive us. It's the one who's arrogant and pride and say, there's nothing wrong with me. I haven't done anything, that God rejects and turns his head. Until they come with a heart of repentance, then God will look back on them and he will forgive them. Because that's the attitude of Satan, his pride. He say, I haven't done anything wrong. It's not me, it's you, but you, God, you're the one who's wrong. But God has forgiven you, Melissa. He's forgiven me. He's forgiven all of us for our wrongdoing. So he's gonna grant you this spiritual divorce, and you're gonna be totally free. So no more that spirit who claimed to be your husband is gonna be on the side of the bed with you. No more. And if it. Because Satan has more demons out there. If one of them even come trying to touch you, Holy Spirit is gonna make you alert and aware, and you say, Holy Ghost, fire. And when you say fire, that fire of God's gonna come out your mouth, and that thing is gonna run in terror. Run in terror. it's gonna happen with this, so praise his holy name. Because I'm not gonna sit here and tell you it's not gonna happen again. Because Satan don't take no for an answer. Lord said we don't have to fear. We just call on his name. You keep calling on his name, Satan keep running. After a while, he'll get tired. So I'm not going to bother Melissa with that anymore. She has totally rejected me. She knows now. So that's what you're going to have to do. For your husband, again, wait on the lead of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is going to give you a perfect timing where you can share with your husband. Now, you can share with your husband your knowledge about, you know, this situation and tell him what the Lord had revealed to me about these spirit spouses sleeping in the middle. The husband looking at a spirit husband looking at you, the spirit wife looking at him. So then after your deliverance in the bedroom, that spirit husband is not going to be there looking at you, but that spirit wife will still be there looking at him. And you tell him that. You tell them that because that's going to happen. Then what you and I can do, we're going to ask the Father, because he's not going to believe you. We're going to ask the Father to open his spiritual eyes and let him see that thing. Let him see it because he don't believe. Let him see. I remember I'll be in the bed with my husband, probably it was in the early 90s. Now, I just give my heart to the Lord, got serious about him, and we'd be sleeping at night, and my back would be toward my husband, and he would be punching me with his elbow, hitting me with his elbow, and I would say, I would still look, you know, my back would still be toward him, and I'd be looking out, and I would say, with my eyes closed, Lord, why did he keep hitting me? I haven't done nothing to him. Why did he keep punching me with his elbow? Night after night, he would do that. And night after night, I would say the same thing. Lord, why he keep punching me with his elbow? Why? I haven't done anything to him. Why? I guess the Lord just got tired of me saying the same thing over and over and over. So this particular night, he did it again, and I said the same thing. And so I rolled over, and the Lord said, open your eyes. I said, He said, open your eyes. Melissa, I opened my eyes and I quickly closed them tight. Help me, Jesus, 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 help me, Jesus. And that is what I kept saying very rapidly because what I saw was not my husband. And the Lord said, that's who it is that keep poking you. And at that time, I didn't know nothing about spiritual spouses. All I did, I kept saying, Jesus, help me, because I did not want to look at my husband and see that spirit. Because I would take it out on my husband, so I asked the Lord, Lord, help me to love my husband, help me to see my husband, in spite of what you let me see that's in him, help me. And the Lord did that, and so many years went by, the Lord worked his work where my husband got delivered, So that's what you do. The Lord making you aware of this truth after your deliverance, that spirit woman is going to be right there, but you don't look at your husband differently, Melissa. Don't do that. Because remember, that's that spirit. That is not your husband. You still love him. You still treat him the way the Lord wants you to love and the way the Lord wants you to treat him. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
You hear me? I'm telling you, that's what you need to do. Because it's not the enemy going to use the knowledge that you have and trying to get you to go against your husband when the Lord said your battle is not with flesh and blood. It's not with flesh and blood. It's with the demon spirit. You have to show that spirit woman, spirit wife, that's what they call themselves, that that is your husband, and it is not going to have your husband. So you keep lifting him up in prayer, and you keep trusting and believing God that the same God who delivered you will eventually deliver him. But in the meantime of his deliverance, you treat him no differently. When you see that spirit in him acting up, you go in the bathroom and you say, in the name of Jesus, I bind you, spirit wife. Turn him loose. Leave him alone. And you go back in his face and you smile and you just smile. This is what to do. The reason I'm telling you this is because this is what I did. This is what I did. But the main thing is don't let the enemy turn you against your husband. Because if you do that, then he had not won that battle. Because he's going to try to separate the marriage. So you don't look at him any differently because he's not your enemy, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So I'm gonna pray for you. Now, this is important. I don't know why the Lord helped me to really harp on this. He really helped me to harp on this. So the Holy Spirit is talking to you about it. So I'm going to pray for you, and then I'm going to, by faith, seek this disconnection where this thing that's calling itself to be your husband got to go in Jesus' name, because God did not establish that relationship. So, Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for your daughter, Melissa. Father, I thank you for not only her, her husband, her family. Father, I thank you that every plan, every purpose, every idea that you have for Melissa and her family, it shall come to pass. And Father, you said, whosoever you join together, let no man, that means a human, a demon spirit that's calling itself to be a man, put asunder. I thank you, Father, that this marriage shall continue to grow stronger and stronger in union in the Holy Spirit. And I thank you, Father, for what you're about to do in this family life. And I ask you, Father, give Melissa more wisdom, revelation of your word. Help her to know who she is in you and who you are in her. Give her a keen insight of your word, Father, keen understanding of your word, Father. Father, I ask you, Father, to give her a forgiving heart, Father, as you have forgiven her, Father. Father, help her to forgive others of their wrongdoing as you have forgiven her, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Because, Father, you have forgiven all of us for our wrongdoing. But you said, Father, that if we don't forgive others of their wrongdoing, then you cannot forgive us because we're holding against others things that they have done towards us. But, Father, you are not holding against us what we have done towards you. And I thank you, Father, for letting Melissa see this truth. I thank you, Father, that you have closed off every door of the enemy in preventing Melissa's total freedom, her total deliverance. I thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. So right now, in the name of Jesus, you spirit husband, in the name of Jesus, pack your load and you get out of God's house. Melissa's body is the temple of God. Holy Ghost fire burn. Burn God's temple. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Melissa's mind. Burn all evil thoughts out of her mind. Burn all evil images out of her mind, burn in her will, burn in her emotions, and burn in her body. Holy Ghost fire, burn in her mouth, burn on her lips, burn everywhere on her body that is a mort and there is a hole. Burn by your fire, burn in her belly, burn in her belly, burn in her womb, burn in her ovaries, burn every part that is not of you, Holy Spirit. Burn all manner of darkness and evil out in Jesus' mighty name. Spirit husband, pack your load in Jesus' name and get out of God's house. Get out of God's house. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire, set that body ablaze. Set ablaze in Jesus' mighty name. I take the scissors of God and I cut. And I separate and detach her from that ungodly covenant of dodging witchcraft. I disconnect her from every relationship that is not of God. For the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus have set her free. The blood of Jesus has forgiven her and her ancestors. The blood of Jesus is against you. You have no more legal right. Burn in her ears, Holy Spirit. Burn that tune. Burn that song. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, burn, burn. Silence the voices. Silence the voices. I burn every voice that is not of God. Holy Ghost fire, burn every voice that is not of God. Burn, 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 burn in Jesus' name. I silence your voice. I silence those voices. I silence in the name of Jesus. You loose her. You cut out. Cut out her ears. Cut out. Holy Ghost fire burn in her ears. Burn in her ears. Burn in her ears. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, 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 burn in her ears. Burn in her ears, Holy Spirit. Burn, 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 burn every manner of darkness and evil. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, you come out in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for sending the angels in the spirit realm and gather every spirit that is not of you, Father, and send them where you desire to send them in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, be free, Melissa. Be free in your mind. Be free in your will. Be free in your emotions. And be free in your body. Now, Holy Ghost, fire, burn. Burn in Melissa's home. Burn. Go from room to room, from in closet to closet, corner to corner, crevice to crevice. Burn under the house. Burn over the house, around the house. Burn under the bed. Burn over the bed. Burn around the bed. Burn. Holy Ghost, fire, burn. Set her mattress ablaze, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, burn, burn. I command all manner of darkness and evil to leave her property. Holy Ghost, fire. Holy Ghost, fire. Burn, burn, burn on her properties. Burn on her properties, Holy Spirit. Everything that move, walk, talk, sound, and that don't act like you, burn, Holy Spirit, by your fire. Burn, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I thank you for setting this captive free. I thank you, Father, for purifying Melissa and Karen. Purify her ears. Purify everywhere that is a hole, everywhere there is a mark. I thank you, Father, for purifying, refreshing it by your fire. Fire, Holy Ghost. Now, Father, I ask you to fill Melissa. Fill her with your spirit. Fill her mind. Fill her will. Fill her emotion. Fill her body. Fill her with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I thank you in Jesus' name. Melissa,
mm-hmm.
You are free. You are free. In Jesus' name, you are free. Do you believe you are free, Melissa? Do you believe that Jesus did his will on earth as he done in heaven?
Yes.
Do you believe?
Yes, ma'am.
So when someone do something for you, what you always say afterward?
Holy Ghost fire.
Do you say, thank you? Thank you, Jesus, for setting me totally free.
Thank you, Jesus, for setting me totally free. Hallelujah.
You are free. You are free. You are free. You know what? The Lord said, whether you believe or not, he done it. It's done.
Oh, I felt
because his grace and mercy. It's because his grace and mercy. Now, as I was ministering, what was happening? Were those spirits trying to talk to you? Were they telling you some things in your hearing, in your ears, as I was ministering the prayer?
No, it felt like little balls rolling off.
Rolling off from where?
Like more so around my head, neck, arm. Not much. I mean, not my private parts, but just my upper body is rolling
mm-hmm.
off.
Mm-hmm.
Face.
Did you feel something was going on in your ears? In your ears?
No, just more so my head and my face and
okay. that. But that's where they came out. They came out of the ears, because that's where they had entered through the ears.
Oh.
And they're coming out through the ears, and they were talking. They were talking. But that's the reason why the Holy Spirit had me to tell them, you know, silence those voices. Because, and also to burn that tomb, they were the ones who will always remind you of that tomb, because that's how they came in, through that tomb. That actually was a trauma for a little girl. That was traumatized there, and they used that tomb. But you are totally, totally free. You are free. You are totally free. That spirit is no longer attached to you. You are totally free. Now you just maintain your freedom. You maintain your deliverance. And like I said, now, Melissa, when you look at your husband, look at your other husband through Jesus' eyes. Just like Jesus looked at you and he saw you. Those spirits were there when he looked at you, but he was looking at you. He saw his loving child. She loved him. So he refused to allow you to stay in that condition. So now you look at your husband through the eyes of Jesus and have compassion in your heart toward your husband. And, but at the same time, you trust in the Lord that God is going to free him, because I'm joining my faith to your faith that the Father, through Jesus Christ by his Spirit, will let your husband see. Now, this is what it's going to take for your husband to believe, to see that demon that is claiming him to be his wife, to let him see it. He's going to have to see it. So don't be surprised when he says, honey, guess what I saw? You know, he may see it in a dream or he may see it naturally. Either way, he's going to see it. And when he see it, he come back to you and mention to you, you say, the Lord, through his servant, told me this was going to happen. So I need for you to call and get delivered as I got delivered. Because I'm asking the Lord to expose, show us what's on the inside of us. Show us who are you. We are yielding the members of our body in obedience to. And like I said, some people, especially men, they're just more hoarder. To get to believe God's word than a female. That's why you have so many females that end up following God. So it's going to take differently for a man. He's going to have to see. And the Lord is going to let him see. And I thank God in advance for it, so that it could bring him to repentance, so that he can get delivered, so that he can fulfill his destiny in Christ Jesus. Now, do you two have any children?
Yes, we do.
Okay, good. And what I want now, what ages are they?
14 and 11.
Okay. What I want you to do, I want you to, as their mother, because your husband's not delivered yet, I want you to lay your hands on each one of them. I want you to bless them. And then the same way you heard me pray for you, I want you to pray for them, okay? Pray for them. They are of age, okay? This is very important, because you could believe if those spirits are in the parent and parents are the children covering, well, then the same spirit that is in the parent is going to be in the children. And they just waiting, the spirits and the children just waiting for it. An appropriate time for them to manifest themselves. But praise God, we're going to stop that. They're coming out of that house. But so you as the mother, you can lay your hands on them and you can do that. And start and monitor their dream. You know, give them a conversation. So tell mommy, what have you been dreaming? Share with me your dream. It's like you ask your husband, you need to ask your children. You need to ask your children, you know. Tell me, have you been experiencing anything? Have you been seeing unusual things happening at night in your bedroom? Have you been seeing things? Or just to share with me. And when they do say, yeah, mama, we saw blah, blah, blah. And you say, you know what? I did too. But you know what? God set me free, and he's going to set you free. So come on, we're coming against this in Jesus' name. So, you know, you have to do that for your children, because, again, if it's happening to the parent and the parent is the child's covering, well, then it's happening to the child or the children. Okay?
Now, I do have one child here. I don't know if you have time, but I can ask them.
Well, what I want to do, I'm going to get both of them together, make it a family. Not so much your husband, because he's not delivered yet. Probably best to do it when he's not around, because he's not delivered yet, and the enemy through him is gonna hinder. So you just get with those with the two children and just trust the Holy Spirit to bring out that conversation. Mm-hmm. Now the 14-year-old. Now is that a boy or girl?
A girl.
Now, the 14-year-old is of age. Now, after you speak to her and she say, "Mommy, you know what? You know, I want to get delivered, and you're not comfortable. Since she's of age, then I can talk to her. You can refer her." But that 11-year-old, that is something you're gonna have to do, because now is that a boy or girl? 11-year-old. A girl.
A boy.
You said a boy. Now, that 11-year-old is not of age, so that's something that you, as his mother, you're going to have to do, okay?
Okay.
Okay. But you can do both of them, but if the 14-year-old say that, you know, that they want to talk to me about it, then you can just call in and have them to come on, because they are of age. But the 11-year-old is underage, so it's best that the mother, the parent, do it, okay? All right. Well, praise God. Thank God. I give him praise. Everything is all right now. That spirit is gone. You don't have no one legal right to come trying to kiss you on the lips and try to touch you or interfere in your life, because you're no longer attached to that ungodly covenant. They are gone. So Jesus Christ divorced you and separated you from it. And you are on the new covenant, blood covenant in Christ Jesus. So everything is perfect in Christ Jesus. It's done. So you just go and tell what great things God has done for you, and you just magnify his name and glorify his holy name. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Praise the living God. Woo, girl, thank you. I thank God for you calling in ago. It made me spiritually angry, you telling me this thing kissing you on the lips. Oh, it made me angry. Whew, Jesus, we magnify you. We thank you. I'm telling you, girl, when you become to really see what Jesus does, you will just praise him all day long. You just thank him. I just thank him. I
mm-hmm.
thank him. I thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, it just gives me so much joy to see my Lord and Savior setting captives free, setting them free from these so-called spirit lovers. Oh, and you will be surprised, Melissa, how it is happening a lot. There's a young girl, and she still have not called me today, Melissa. That young lady still have not called me today. And she confessed that this spirit manifests. First, it started out like it started out with you, you know, kissing on the lips or doing stuff like that. And it does that to see if you're going to receive it. And when you receive it, it promotes you in the spirit realm, and then it'll start manifesting. She said this thing manifested in the bed with her. You hear what I'm saying, Melissa? She said it manifested as a man in the bed with her. And she took her finger and poked it. I guess she poked it to see if it was real.
Mm.
And do you know, the girl, I scheduled a time of deliverance, and that demon convinced her not to show up.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, girl, can you imagine what that demon is doing to her? But she allowed it. Are you listening to what I'm saying? This thing is showing up as a human man. It took on a form of a body of a man, but it's a spirit on the inside. And she's sleeping with it.
Wow.
This thing was going on with God's children.
Oh, my goodness.
I said, Lord, you did your part. You led her to her human helper. She allowed this spirit.
Well, maybe we should pray for that she'll, you know, call.
Well, that's all we can do is pray. But she got her will. The people don't realize persons have her will. I pray for her. That's what we can do, pray. But the Lord said they have their will. Her eyes are no longer blind. Her eyes is open to this thing. This is the difference when you are blind and you don't know. But she knows now. And sad thing about it is that she ministers on YouTube. So everybody who connects with her don't realize when they connect, the moment they connect, it pulls them also into that kingdom of darkness.
Oh,
this is what, see, this one example. There's many, many, many more. This is what's going on. You know, you can, you know, and I can't call her name enough, but you can, you know, keep her in prayer because God knows her name. But I'm just sharing with you how some people are not blind. They know what they're doing. They have, that they have chosen to continue to coexist with demons.
Mm-hmm.
But we praise God that you refuse to coexist with demons. And I thank God for many others who refuse to coexist with demons. Praise his holy name. All right, Melissa, I see the young lady from Florida took off her mute, so let me check and see if she's still just listening or she's calling for a deliverance session. Because this is a deliverance session. You know, sometimes people want to call in and just talk, but that's not the purpose of this line. The purpose of this line is to set captives free. So you continue, Melissa, to stay and walk in obedience to God and maintaining your deliverance in Jesus' name. And, you know, and if you need to talk, just go to the website, thechildrensmic.org, and submit a general request to let me know. And as soon as I'm available, I'll give you a call back. But in the meantime, you share what great things God has done for you.
Yes.
In Jesus' name. Okay?
Yes.
All right. Well, stay blessed. Let me still check with the lady from Georgia. Is she still listening? Then I'll just go ahead and end the program for today. But you continue to stay blessed in Jesus' name. Okay?
Thank you.
All right, then. Bye-bye. Praise God, dear heart. You know, I want to thank everybody for joining in today's program. I just thank God for sending captives to be set free, because Jesus' will is that we be totally free. I just praise him and thank him. For every individual that he sends, I just thank him, because it's him who actually makes this program known. You know, I don't have to do no advertising anywhere. I just mainly depend on God, because he told me to make myself available, and he will send people, those he have chosen, he was sent to be delivered. And I thank God for that. So, again, I come on live every Wednesday and Thursday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and you can call 724-444-7444 and enter call ID 139732, or you can visit the web. Go to thechildrensmic.org for information on how to join us via the web. But, dear heart, again, I want to thank you, and I look forward to you tuning in again on next week. Shalom.